Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Happy 5:30 in the morning. Today is Sunday, September 5th, and if you're watching this, this is the first in a series of 7 vlogs that I'm putting out about what a week in the Disney College program is like. First things first, it means waking up at the butt crack of dawn to go to work. So my shift starts at 7 and I still gotta get ready, so I'll see y'all in just one sec. Okay, showered and ready to go. Let me tell you guys, today did not start off very cash money. Hey, this is a PSA to if you live in Flamingo Crossing. If you live in Flamingo Crossing or any apartment building and you have people beneath you, you do not need to be stomping around for 3 to 4 straight hours at night. Let me tell you that. I probably got maybe like 4 hours total of sleep last night. So today is gonna be an adventure. But it's all good. It's all good. Am I totally sleepy? Oh, for certain. And I left my coffee cup at work, so we're gonna have to improvise for caffeine this morning. But anywho, today I am working in the amenities room, which is why I'm up so early. What the amenities room is basically all of the little free things that you would have in your hotel room, you know, little soaps, little conditioners, maybe you have a little pack of coffee to go with the coffee machine, whatever, all this kind of stuff. It comes from the amenities room. So what my day is gonna be is I'm gonna start out, I guess it's kind of weird to explain, but I'll explain it with like a housekeeper's cart. I'm working on 2 parts of the housekeeper's cart today. One is most of the hotel rooms have little like refillable shampoo, conditioner, body wash that the housekeeper just refills as needed. So I am the person who goes in and puts the refills of shampoo, body wash, conditioner on all of the carts. That's step one of my day. Step two is gonna be organizing the amenity trays for the housekeeping carts, which is literally just putting like bars of soap, dish towels, trash bags, just organizing stuff on trays. That's gonna take up most of my day. This is a pretty chill shift, to be honest with you. Other than like the shampoo and stuff, it's mostly just standing in place all day organizing. Nothing too crazy. A little outline of what I'm gonna be doing for the rest of the day. Later on in this video, I'm gonna take you guys along grocery shopping with me. Ooh. And I'm going to go see Shang-Chi tonight, and I am so excited. Everybody's saying it's like one of the best Marvel movies, period. Best thing since Iron Man. I've heard literally nothing but good things about it, and I'm pumped. Ooh, another thing that is not cash money is something on my camera went wrong this morning, and now like the little flip screen isn't working, and I like have a hair tie around it to keep the screen facing up. I don't know what's going on there. You know, week in life, your camera might start breaking down. Yeah, the series is gonna go from the series is gonna go from Sunday to Saturday of next week. So if you wanna stay tuned, feel free to hit the subscribe button, follow me along. Ooh, it's too much. You can never have too much love. Isn't that right, everybody? So, not sponsored or anything, but one bad habit that I really did pick up whenever I was in isolation last week, 2 weeks ago, whatever, was that I just kept picking at my like lip skin, and it made them super dry, and like now they're kind of like discolored, like it's lasting consequences. So I went to Walmart yesterday and I got some special like lip therapy sunscreen ultra moisturizing lip gloss or chapstick, whatever. This is how I'm gonna be rocking for the next 1 to 2 weeks, I think. That's about all the cosmetics I put on to go to work, lotion and some chapstick. I will put some moisturizer on though, because something about Florida, man, it dries out my skin like nobody's business. Like for my first couple weeks here, I had like alligator skin and I could not figure out why. I was like, what's the issue? Like you'd think because it's so humid that my skin would be kind of moisturized.
No,
that's not how that works apparently.
Now I'm shiny all over.
And last thing in here is we gotta take our vitamins, kids. And just like that, I'm as strong as a mule.
Okay, I have about 12 minutes before I need to be on the road, so it's time for breakfast and then we'll Autobots roll out.
What's the drink of the day gonna be? I think we're feeling monster oat milk. And we might be feeling a core water later. We'll see.
Fit check. Whoa. Wow. Styling on them.
I don't know if they're showing up on screen, but every morning there's millipedes all around and you wake up and you say hello to them.
Car time, Lisa here. Speaking of the morning millipede, something I forgot to mention that also isn't cash money is that I saw an ant on my bed. If you live here at Flamingo Crossing, you know that we have various bugs of various natures and sizes and kind. The most common are ants and millipedes. The ants usually don't bother you. They're like sugar ants and they like scurry away if you like walk up to them or whatever. But the fact that I saw an ant, it was just one ant on my bed. I was like, I thought my bed was sacred. I had literally never seen an ant on my bed. It really threw me off this morning. There was a slug in my shower yesterday. There was a millipede crawling behind the toilet. It's really something over here. You become one with nature. You know what I mean? And that, who doesn't want to become one with nature? Am I right? Am I right, kids? Anywho, we are on our way to the Riviera. For breakfast today, I am having one of my monster oat milk coffees and a little pack of peanut butter crackers. And you're probably not gonna see me till the end of the day, so I might as well show you for lunch. I'm having one of these rices that my mom sent to me in the mail. It's like pineapple, jalapeno, and like pulled pork kind of thing. These are so good. We're also having trail mix and a half of a protein cookie, and that'll be my lunch for today. It's about 6:32 and I am moving right along, right on time. It takes me like 20 minutes to actually get into work, so you have to leave half an hour before. I have arrived at the Riviera. My coffee is not kicking in. Definitely still sleepy, but it's gonna be a good day. I just have to say it's gonna be a good day, and it is. Today is gonna be the best day ever. For now, it is time for me to go clock in and do my time. I will see you in 8 hours.
One shift later.
Ooh, it's toasty, straight up. Ooh-wee. Look at this, it's 102 degrees. Well, hello. It is the end of the day, the end of the work day, and now my free time officially begins. The amenities room is super self-paced, real independent, so I'm mostly in there by myself. Pretty relaxed day, pretty normal, nothing crazy. I really have the whole rest of the day to kick around town. That's what I'm gonna do. I think technically, as long as I took my name tag off, I could like go out in public like this. I've seen people in their uniforms and stuff, or their costumes out and about, but I think that's super weird. So yeah, I'm gonna go home and change clothes real quick, and then we can get this party started. What is today's music vibe?
So, I'm changed. I'm almost ready to hit the streets. We got the Deadpool taco truck, some plain skinny jeans, and some Van-looking Skechers. That's the fit for the movies. Now, what am I gonna do with my hair? I've been staring at it for a while. How about this? I'll let you guys in on a secret. When I wear bandanas, it's because I don't feel like styling my hair. Ooh, now you know. I don't think I said it earlier in the video. This series is inspired by Emily Enchanted. Back when she did her Disney College program, she did a week in the life and she posted a video every single day, and that was really cool. I remember when I saw her doing that, like I was watching it like live at the time that she was posting them, I was like, that is so cool, you know, wow.
out. 7 videos in 7 days. But now that I'm like here and I have my channel, it definitely does sound like a challenge.
But we're gonna do it, guys. We're really gonna do it. This is the like learning the ropes of daily vlogging day. I'm not feeling this and I don't know how to fix it. It's one of those days. My hair just does not want to cooperate. Dealing with my hair down here in Florida has definitely been something. I'm somebody who usually wears my hair straight, but I just got the last part of my relaxer cut out a couple months ago, so I'm kind of natural. But the issue is, I really don't know how to style curly hair. Like, this last couple months is probably the longest I've gone without like straightening my hair every week or whatever. So now that it's curly all the time, I don't really know what to do. So if you guys have any tips for newly naturals, I know my blonde makes me not natural, but like, other than that, and then we just throw a bandana on it. I can work with that. Are we working with that? Are we feeling it? It'll do. While I finished getting ready, there's been all sorts of news happening since I posted my last news video. So there's been at least 2 new like job opportunities. One was like VIP tours, like you could be an assistant to like the VIP tours people, which sounded really cool. It was $15.95 like pay rate. You'd be working with VIPs. It sounded so cool. I would have signed up for that immediately, except for the fact that I am not qualified because I have not had my license for 3 years. That's one of the like basic requirements, that you would have had your license for 3 years, aka there is an age requirement. Like, you basically have to be 21 and up to do it, because you have to have had a valid US license for 3 or more years. Kind of lame, but that's all good. And the other one was a housekeeping opportunity, for which I've had many questions. What is my advice? Am I gonna do it? Should you do it? I salute people who are currently housekeepers. And if you do it, I salute you too. There's incentives. You can extend your program and be a housekeeper. Not a house person, not what I do, a housekeeper. They're paying $15 an hour and a full month's rent here at Flamingo Crossing if you sign up for that and you get approved or whatever. That's all I have to say. Ren Disney, they just announced their little like Ren Disney marathon medals. They're so cute. They put all 6 of them out, and as a Dopey Challenge participant, I will be getting all 6 of these bad boys. Wow, imagine me a winner. And I would be training for it in the gym today, but today is Sunday, and on Sundays, I do not work out. I chill, I rest. On Sundays, we rest. But every other day, I will be hitting the gym and getting swole. As you guys can see, I'm already quite the athlete. Which one is the gun show? Oh, wait. Pow!
I'm built different.
I actually am working on my upper body strength. Wait till my results come in. Y'all won't be able to tell me nothing. Nothing at all. Now is as good a time as any to say, I've been struggling. I like a lot of types of YouTube videos, but the ones I mostly like are like video essays. Like, I'm talking like 30 plus minutes. If it's an hour, that's great. If it's 2 hours, even better. I like really long form content, but I recognize that that's not for everybody. In fact, maybe not even for most people, but that's my thing. I've kind of been trying to find a balance on my channel of like, okay, I know not everybody would want to watch a 45 minute long video, but that is my style. So like, I don't know, if you guys have any suggestions about like, do you guys like the longer videos? These ones I'm putting out for this week in my life are probably gonna be shorter. Do you guys like shorter videos? I don't know. I mean, feel free to sound off in the comments. Are those even? Not really, but cousins, not sisters. Or wait, no, sisters, not twins. And I have to put on my little lip medicine again.
It really is helping. Like, the difference of this morning to yesterday is absolutely crazy.
Back to the car. We are going to the store.
Guys, I came to the sketchy Walmart.
This is the Walmart where all the tourists come, and it's always crazy busy, so this is gonna be quite the gamble.
Welcome to Wally World.
Walmart, but these ears, these Spider-Man No Way Home ears are dropping in 30 seconds at 6 o'clock, and we are gonna get it. I got my sister Lauren on the phone. Say hello.
What's poppin'? Don't mind me, just watching.
It's refreshing. I have really bad service in the parking lot, and I'm scared. Oh, Lauren, do you have any words of wisdom for the viewers out there?
Yes, I was just thinking about it. While my sister is waiting for then I wanted to say hi, YouTube. I hope that you all keep it popping on the Sunday. I hope that you are thriving and surviving, manifesting and driving towards your goals, YouTube. You got this thing. Yes, you do.
Y'all got all that? Okay, I got it. Yeah. I have Spider-Man No Way Home ears in the mail. How is your Sunday going? Anyways, back to the apartment to drop off the groceries.
Disney Springs.
At Disney Springs, and I'm gonna get some dinner very soon, but I want to take my thumbnail before the sun goes down, so I'm gonna hurry over to AMC real quick. Like 30 minutes to get a picture for my thumbnail. I thought I would be like calm, cool, and collected. It'd be no big deal. I could just ka-ching. That was so awkward. But I finally got some nice lady to take the picture. So shout out to lady. Thank you. But now I'm on my way to Blaze Pizza for dinner. Wait, before we go anywhere else, let's see if we can bump into Emily Enchanted at this little Disney Springs Zara she's always talking about. When I am a CEO, this is the kind of stuff I'm gonna wear. Hillary Banks. Yeah, I think this jacket, I just kind of love it. Like this material, this style. I call it the Hillary Banks jacket. Apparently it's in. Let's pretend I can afford it for a second. The collection really wasn't giving this year, you know? I've seen Zara do better, maybe next season. Okay, so here is my Blaze pizza. We got the spicy chorizo, vegan cheese, spinach, and black olives, garlic, salt, and pepper. And then I made an Arnold Palmer as my drink. Okay, I'll try my drink first. Arnold Palmer. And my first slice of the famed Blaze pizza. Delicious.
That's like really good.
Well, I'm gonna devour this. I'll talk to y'all in just a second. Hey, I'm halfway through. I was really expecting this to be like a Domino's pizza, like a Little Caesar situation. It's literally delicious. They even asked me if they needed, like if I wanted them to change gloves or whatever because I asked for vegan cheese. I was like, never heard of that.
10 out of 10 thus far, and I'm only halfway through.
RIP, rest in slices to this pizza.
I'm hanging out in front of the AMC. I walked back over here, but I'm waiting for my food to settle. because that was a lot. I'm very stuffed. While we're out here chilling before the movie starts, we got a little under an hour. Got about 45 minutes until it starts. But the streets have been saying this Shang-Chi movie is like the best Marvel movie. They're saying it's one of the greats. So I'm excited. The trailers look kind of so-so, but apparently it's worthwhile and I'm gonna have a great time and it might be my new favorite. That's what everybody says. But yeah, I'll probably go in and get my seat pretty soon and watch all these fun nifty previews. Ooh, they might show the No Way Home trailer in this movie. I'm excited. Okay, let's go inside. We're seeing it in Dolby.
Real quick, I just realized this is the same fit as what I wore to Universal.
The special little like Shang-Chi thingy. They do have the red carpet. Ooh. What a movie. The streets were right. That was a banger, an absolute banger. The only half criticism I have of the movie is that I don't like Awkwafina. I am anti-Awkwafina, but even she wasn't that distracting. It was a good movie. I made a list of everything I liked in Shang-Chi. I liked the soundtrack. First song that played, a banger. The bus scene, 10 out of 10. There was a Kung Fu Hustle poster somewhere in this movie, and that is when I knew that I was in for a ride. I freaking love Kung Fu Hustle. It's a great movie. Go watch it. The fight choreography, amazing. At one point, one of the characters says, if you aim at nothing, you hit nothing. How wise, such wisdom. And finally, the costumes. Everyone looked spectacular. So yeah, go see Shang-Chi. It was absolutely worth it. I got a bad seat. I didn't realize that the seats would be all like tiered the way they were, but Dolby Cinema had the benefit of like every time there was a fight or a boom or something, you felt it in your chair. But this was definitely like a 3D movie. So I don't know, if I see it again, I'm gonna see it in 3D and compare and contrast, but awesome movie, loved it.
Gee, I wonder where my car could be.
So that concludes my Sunday episode of my Week in the Life special. Some key takeaways from today. When I was at Disney Springs, I realized something crucial. It is so much less awkward for me to take like a thumbnail or just a picture in general if I just hand somebody my cell phone instead of the camera. I was literally struggling so much. Like before I went to the movies, after I went to the movies, they had this like really cute setup for like the Shang-Chi movie, this little promo area thing. It was so cute and I wanted to take a picture, but I kept hesitating. I was like, I'll wait till this group goes. And eventually they turned off the lights and it was a mess and it was dark outside at that point. So I kind of flopped in that regard. I don't know what I'm gonna do for this video's thumbnail. We'll figure it out. But in conclusion, today I went to work. We did a little grocery shopping. We went to Disney Springs, had a little Blaze pizza, and we saw Shang-Chi. What a day. Right now it's about 1:30 in the morning. I'm about to sit and edit this video that you're watching right now. Whoa. But if you've made it this far in the video, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Toodles!